For those of you out there who use 3D printers that are equipped with heated beds, here is an alternative print bed adhesion method that utilizes a small amount of water and ordinary table sugar. That's it. I believe this method may only work on heated beds, but this needs to be tested and proven at another time. As far as I can tell, as of the time of this video, no one out there has tried this method yet, so that's kind of interesting. For me, this method works effectively using a heated tempered glass covered bed while printing common PLA filament. I'm not equipped to test higher temperature filaments such as ABS, so somebody else needs to test that out. And here is my method. Take one single heaping teaspoon of sugar and combine it with about 4 level teaspoons of cold water in a small microwave safe bowl. Next, heat the mixture in order to dissolve the sugar for about 10 seconds and stir. If sugar crystals are still visible in the bowl, heat again for another 5 to 10 seconds, but stop heating just as boiling starts. Carefully stir the hot mixture until all the sugar crystals have totally dissolved into the liquid to create a clear but sticky liquid sugary solution. Let the hot mix cool down a bit before transporting, then carefully bring the solution to the printer. Make sure the bed is accessible and away from the printhead. You might have to disable the steppers in your printer to move the bed to where you will have full access to it. Check your printer's documentation for that info. I found preheating the bed to 60 degrees Celsius works for me. While the bed is warming up to temperature, grab a small square of paper towel. A quarter of a sheet is sufficient because any more than that would be excessive and so would be hard to stop from dripping everywhere. Once the print bed reaches 60 degrees with a solution placed beside the bed, dip in the rolled up towel and squeeze out any excess so as not to make a mess. Then carefully wipe the solution across the glass. Wipe only once when first applying the solution as it will initially just bead up and provide poor coverage. More liquid won't help at this point. It will just smear around, so just wait. Let the solution sit on the bed for only 20 seconds or so to let the water evaporate out. Now for the second and final time, dip the towel once more and wipe over the glass plate. This time you should notice that the solution will spread and stick more thoroughly and evenly. And coverage will be more complete as the previously applied sticky layer will grab even more of the sugar solution from the towel. Don't dip anymore, but instead just wipe the same towel again one more time in the opposite direction to give a final thin coat to the glass. This whole bed surface treatment, once started, should take less than 2 minutes to complete. One note on this, if you encounter a problem with, for example, getting the sweet solution where you don't want it, a paper towel moistened with clean water will easily wipe away your mistakes. After treating your printer bed, level it. So here are my findings. As shown in the Wikipedia link below in the notes of this video, sugar, also known as sucrose, decomposes into a sticky caramel substance at 186 degrees Celsius. Sound familiar? That is the lower end temperature for print nozzles that are printing PLA. What I believe may be happening is as the hot PLA is being deposited directly onto the warm sugar covered bed at 210 degrees, at the point of contact, the hot PLA instantaneously caramelizes the sugar layer, which then immediately cools back down to 60 degrees. I believe this is how the printed object locks onto the bed. More input is definitely needed on this from people with brains and, of course, knowledge. I found excellent bed adhesion so far on all my prints where the bed has been leveled properly. The sugar layer stays relatively sticky as long as the bed is at 60 degrees. Yet when allowed to cool down to room temperature, it becomes far less sticky, much like an ordinary candy. Something else that's interesting is even if the printer isn't used for several days, when the print bed is again reheated, I found the bed stickiness returns as the bed temperature approaches 60 degrees Celsius. If the bed is allowed to cool down to 20 degrees, the printed pieces literally pop off the bed with the slightest of effort. Repeatedly, I've also been able to print more than once on the treated glass bed with only one sugar treatment. And finally, if you would like to completely clean off the glass bed, simply place the glass under slightly warm running water. The glass comes clean almost instantly without the use of any soap, scrapers, or even any rubbing of any kind. The sugar just dissolves nearly instantly. If there is any concern about sugar getting on the print nozzle, I believe there should be no worries, since table sugar softens and caramelizes at 186 degrees, and most nozzles print at 180 degrees or higher, any sugar should theoretically come off with no detriment to the print nozzle. Of course, keep any solutions away from motors and switches because those can't be cleaned easily. So, what are the pros for this? Effective bond to glass when it's 60 degrees Celsius, releases when cooled down automatically, easily rinses off with water or moist cloth, paper towel, can be used more than once to a point, easy to apply, can be found at home, can be made in minutes, no tape, no glue, no scrapers, no hairspray, no fumes, and it's cheap. And the cons for this? It may not work well using unheated beds, unknown adhesive strength for other filaments, and it needs more research. This method really needs to be investigated using other filaments, printers, and other scenarios. I hope this video will help you with your future print routines. Please let me know what you think in the comments below and share if you found this interesting. Thanks again for watching.